Dear colleagues, the Kronig-Venus insufficiency by definition is any functional abnormality of venous circulation. It is a cascade of pathological events that result from ambulatory venous hypertension or failure of adequately lower the venous pressure with exercise. So proper classification is needed to standardize the reporting and the treatment of the diverse manifestation of CVI and allow uniform diagnosis and comparison of patient population. So the SIAB or the clinical, etiological, anatomical, and pathological classification is created by American Venous Forum in 1996, revised in 2004, and revised again in 2020, and now is accepted standard for classifying CVI. What is new in 2020 revision? CO is defined more precisely. Two subtypes of C2, the de novo and the recurrent varicose vein, are added. The corona fibrictatica is recognized. Recurrent active ulcer, the C6R, is added. Pelvic and abdominal venous disorder included. The extravenous causes included. The anatomical segment recognized separately. And these are the modifications in the 2020 version of SIAB. The relation of SIAB to clinical practice, the GDG, advised to refer symptomatic varicose vein to vascular service because interventional treatment proved effective, especially for bleeding varicose vein, superficial vein thrombosis, active and healed venous regurgitation. But in class C4 and 6, a deep vein is probably involved by reflux, obstruction, occlusion, or both, and severe MU-cava venous occlusion result in debilitating lower extremity symptoms or signs. The iliac vein occlusion of actually of two types are both thrombotic iliac occlusion due to insufficient recanalization after acute DVT with a variable degree of obstruction, 70 to 80% of cases. It is of two pathological forms, the typical post-thrombotic iliofemoral lesion with irregular stenosis or occlusion, with axial, transpelvic, and ascending lumbar collateral, or the Rocatinesque stenosis that is diffused narrowed long segment of iliac vein with no collateral formation, as in this picture. The second type is non-thrombotic iliac vein lesion, new term to include all type of compression, may Turner Cockett syndrome, or even compression on the right iliac vein. The options available to treat iliac vein occlusion may be compression therapy. It is poorly tolerated by some patients with MU-cava venous obstruction. On the other hand, failed extended compression therapy refers to the possibility of chronic iliac vein occlusion. The second option may be cross-pelvic venous bypass, the Bal-Madel procedure, with low technical success, high rate of complication used in severe cases, or recanalization and stenting, but stenting may fail. So why iliac vein stenting may fail? Maybe due to the type of pathology. The pathology here is fibrosis, not an atherosclerotic plaque as in arteries. So all the area should be covered. And I quoted here, the optimum intravenous stent placement should be from one healthy vein segment to the next, obtaining adequate inflow and outflow. The second cause, pathological cause, is the high elastic limit and yield strength in veins. The occluded vein should have an high elastic limit and yield strength. So compared to arteries, immediate recovery is the rule in most cases, and routine stenting is recommended. Second cause, pathological anatomy is different between the two types of pathology. I already speak about them. And the stent performance is different. So we need a classification system for iliac venous occlusion specifically to ease the decision making, to support the therapeutic decision type, either to use endovenous alone or hybrid or even conservative, and to guide the duration type of anticoagulation, to guide the operator to the best recanalization scenario, to aid scientific reporting, and to predict the outcome. One of the earliest classification of iliac venous occlusion is that of Marston et al. In 2014. It mimics the task classification for arterial system with four types, type 1, 2, 3, and 4. Against it mimic again task, but the pathological anatomy in the iliac veins are different, and the key rule of the inflow is not defined in this classification. A second classification is the Raymond England classification of left common iliac compression based on triplanar fibrography. In stage 1, compression of left common iliac vein. Stage 2, we add collateralization. Stage 3, with localized occlusion and collateralization. Stage 4A, with involvement of adjacent venous segment. Stage 4B, with involvement of distal venous segment. Again, it is classification mostly for extrinsic compression, and it is the description of pathological anatomy of venous occlusion and inflow are lacking. The most interesting classification is that of Hohmann classification. He described a classification of common vein, left common vein occlusion into five types with increasing severity. So let us analyze this classification. The pathological anatomy is classified into iliac segment number 1, the common femoral vein station number 2, the involvement of the inflow type 3A femoral vein, and type 3B, the profunda vein. The anatomical extension of pathology below the inguinal ligament. And here, the most important is the grade of lumen reduction in the common femoral and the femoral vein and profunda. Non-relevant resident in percent, risk relevant between 10 and 50, and the hemodynamic relevant more than 50. So this is type 1. Hemodynamic relevant again more than 50. The iliac segment, there is a stenosis at the iliocaval junction. The station of the common femoral vein is free, and the inflow is free, as seen in one of our cases, only the iliocaval junction is stenosed, or this case. And the prognosis of recanalization is good. While type 2, all the iliac segment is occluded. Again, we mean by occlusion, hemodynamically relevant, more than 50%. The station of common femoral vein is normal, and the inflow, the two vessels are normal. The prognosis is also favorable, as in this case. Or type 3, the iliac segment is occluded, and the station is occluded again, and the two vessels of inflow are normal. The prognosis is less favorable, as in this case with extra-pelvic collateralization, or in this case with intra-pelvic collateralization. And then type 4, with iliac segment occluded, the station is occluded, and one of the vessels of inflow are occluded here, the femoral vein, as in this case. Or type 4B, and the inflow here is occluded, the profunda vein is occluded, as in this case. And then the most severe type is type 5. The iliac segment is occluded, the station is occluded, and the two vessels of the inflow are occluded, as in this specific case. I will speak about it later on in a minute. So what may be added to Hohmann classification? May be addition of fourth anatomical segment, popliteal, and the addition of risk factor, سون بوفيريا. What to do to type four? I need time. What to do to type five? Repair of the inflow. The option to repair inflow may be three. Number one, infrainguinal femoropubliteal stenting. Infrapubliteal femoropubliteal stenting as in this diagram by extending recanalization stenting into the femoral vein. Or axial transformation of profunda inflow, making the profunda the main inflow as in this diagram, and just we transform the transvalve collateralization into a cycle collateralization as I quoted here from Gota et al. The third option is the hybrid procedure by open endophlebectomy as we did in this case with total occlusion of the iliac confirmatory station and both inflow. We did endophlebectomy as the femoropubliteal segment, and then we obtained flow in the femoral vein, in the common femoral vein, and the lastly in the common iliac vein and the cava. So, in general, stenting is not advised if the inflow is irreparably compromised. So, no flow to support stent patency. In general, stenting is not advised, severely diseased artery and the heavy fistula has some conclusion. I will conclude. No one previous classification are endorsed yet by Venus Forum. Thrombophilia and important risk factor not included, but the main lesson achieving long-term venous patency by optimization of inflow and the prevention of thrombosis. Thank you.